If you've spent any time in high level, then you know domains are a headache. I am here to break down the key pitfalls that we see after supporting over 20,000 users and how you can avoid them and make domains a peaceful event when you're working with high level. The unique thing about domains in high level is that it's a funnel builder, right? So it's not the same as what you might be used to with other website builders or other hosting services that do some of the things that we expect and take for granted, right? Some of those things might be like, you know, redirecting a domain from the not www version to the www. version, right? Or making sure that when you type in, you know, domain.com/something awesome, it auto redirects to www.domain.com/something awesome, right? Those kind of things that are a little bit technical and we take it for granted, and it just is kind of the root of the issue in high level. And so what I want to do is hop on over to my screen and show you the most robust system, the most robust setup that will eliminate these headaches for good. And honestly, I want to tell you after that, like, how we make it easy for users to also no longer have these headaches. But for you, this is good to know, good to understand, because it is a little bit of a different system, and we've seen it's something you either love if you set it up right the first time, or you hate it because it feels like around every corner it's a different problem. So let's hop into the screen. And so here we are inside of a high level in the domains area, right? And you've probably done this, and you can add a domain. There's a lot of flexibility here. It says you can make an A record pointing to a series of numbers, an IP address, or you can create a CNAME record pointing to flash.funnels.messagesender.com. If you've never dealt with DNS manager or these kind of like domain records and something like this, well, this is going to be an interesting introduction for you. But so I'm going to recommend our favorite tool, and it's completely free, and it's called Cloudflare. Cloudflare was built as kind of like this secondary level for helping manage domains in a better way. So I'll give you a brief lesson on domains. So for domains, there's three tiers at least that are helpful to understand. There is the registrar. This is like, it's like the property, right? It's the actual place. In the internet space, it's like digital real estate. I go, and I might go to like GoDaddy is a registrar, and I buy mattdeseno.com, and I own it, right? We're kind of in the Louisiana, you know, purchase days where I literally just take four stakes and I just pay property taxes, basically 10 bucks a year, 20 bucks a year, whatever it is. It's very cheap. No one else has purchased it before. I bought a domain. It never existed. Now I own it. That's my property. Very, very cool. That registrar has got like these top level ability. It's like they're the land management. Then, and when you go to like a .com, right, they look at all these registrars and they say, who has anyone registered this? Has anyone bought this property yet? And GoDaddy in that example, or Google Domains or whatever it is, says, yes, this has been purchased. It was by Matt. The second level is DNS records, right? And this is like, it's like a address system, right? It defines where to go for particular things. So for example, a website or a funnel, if I type in mattdeseno.com, my registrar could do this. Like GoDaddy does have this ability. Google has this ability to hold the address book of all the different routes where stuff should go to. Because it might be like this for you. My website lives in a different area than my email does, right? And I might have a subdomain that lives in a totally different area than my website, and it lives in a different area than my email, right? So that's what these DNS records levels are. And for a long time, it was really just all in one place. Sometimes everything was in one place. Like I had my domain was registered in GoDaddy, the DNS records were managed by GoDaddy, and my hosting was GoDaddy. Everything was all in one place, right? It's a little bit dangerous because where you run into like problems with malicious activity is, you know, one of the early types of malicious activity was they just sent a boatload of traffic and they try to overwhelm the server, overwhelm wherever the thing is hosted. So this is where Cloudflare comes into play. They realized they could live between your registrar, like a GoDaddy or Google Domains, and your host. And they could be kind of like a bouncer at the front door, where they're just there to really say, are you good traffic or are you bad traffic? And if you're bad traffic, we're not even gonna let you like try to hammer on the door. Like you don't even get a chance to cause distress on the system. You never even make it there. We literally send you out to somewhere else, right? We just kick you out into outer space. So that was one of the perks, security. The other benefit was just better at managing those records, right? So if you've been around for a while, you go into GoDaddy, maybe Google Domains, and I change a record. I'm like, oh, I want to change. I want to make an update like this, right? I want to point my domain at my funnel builder. And you go and you do that, and they say it could take 2 to 24 hours. And you're like, 2 to 24 hours? Why does it take 2 to 24 hours? And they're like, well, because this isn't our full-time job. Like, we're actually mostly a registrar, and like, we do the domain, you know, the DNS records management on the side, right? It's not their main purpose. Cloudflare, that's their main purpose. That's their job. And so when we have an issue, or if we want to make a change, we change it, and it's instant. That's really the two perks and why I love it. I mean, I also mentioned it's free. So it's free, win. It adds some security, win. And it actually makes things a lot faster. Triple win. So there's the triple threat of Cloudflare, why I like them. I couldn't even give you an affiliate link because they're free. And so I'm gonna hop into my screen. I'm gonna show you in Cloudflare the most robust setup. There might be another way to do this. There's a lot of different ways to do this, but I'm showing you a foolproof way to do this so that you get no headaches. I'm gonna show you some of the unique stuff that Cloudflare does that you need someone to do, and that a lot of times other hosts will do it, but funnel builders don't do this. And so I'm gonna hop into Cloudflare. This is what it looks like in the DNS management zone where you're like setting up those records. So we've got like email, which I'm sure I'll show you how to do this with like Mailgun and stuff like that, right? And then we've got the membership area, that's cool. Here we've got two records for this domain right now. I'm looking at thedemoaccount.com. Pretty easy, right? So we've got thedemoaccount.com, and that's my domain. And I want thedemoaccount.com and www.thedemoaccount.com to both work no matter what. In this example, you have to make a decision. Do you want, like, there's no wrong answer, but what version of your domain do you want people to see when it finally loads? Do you want to see in the browser www.thedemoaccount.com, or do you want to see thedemoaccount.com? There's no wrong answer, but you have to make a decision because that's going to affect how we set this up. And so in this scenario, what I've done is I want www.thedemoaccount.com to be the one that resolves. The other one is going to do a perfect redirect. So that way, it doesn't matter what person, what they type in, it's all going to go to the same place. Because maybe you didn't know it, hypothetically, they could go to two different places. I could have two different funnels between www.thedemoaccount.com and just thedemoaccount.com. They could go to two different places. It's become common expectation that they go to the same place because technically, those three W's is a subdomain. That's a funny hack. You could have like two W's go to something totally different, right? Wrap your mind around that. But so this is the ideal setup. I prefer and recommend you set up as a CNAME. It's the simplest thing. We see the least amount of issues with it because it's just words. You can't go wrong. You didn't type in the numbers wrong. Also, hypothetically, IP addresses are funny and that sometimes they get like reassigned and we don't realize it. By using a CNAME, you're always going to this predefined domain, flash.funnels.messagecenter.com, and that actually then redirects to a server IP address. It all ends up being an IP address, but now you're guaranteed to always be right because if the IP address changes, the words aren't gonna change. The CNAME doesn't change. So I recommend setting up a CNAME record. And you see there's two differences. We have both of them set up the same way in the terms of like, I've got the phrase in there. So if I show you, if I were to do this, I click down to the type. If you're just gonna do without the www, you can just put an at sign and it knows, okay, that's the non-www version. And then your target is where you're gonna type in, you know, flash.funnels.messagecenter.com. Then you've got this option for proxy or not proxy. So what we wanna do is the one that we don't want to see, which in my example is the non-W's version, we want that to be proxy on. The one that you do want to see, we want that to be proxy off. I'll get into details about that. So in this example, at, I would turn proxy on for one of them and then proxy off for the other one. The one that I want to see, I've got proxy off, right? Hopefully that makes sense. So now both versions are pointing at high level. Hypothetically, you could add both versions to your high level account in the domains. that would be complicated. You know, why would you want to have like two versions hypothetically pointing to two different domains? You don't want that. So doing this setup, you don't have to do that. I've got both of those CNAME records in there. Now what we want to do is go over to rules. It's kind of a little fancy thing. So in rules, you get a couple free rules. This is how we make sure that it works no matter what and handles that other aspect of like, what about what happens after the domain? Like /something awesome. Because you've maybe seen some other simple solutions where you just set up a simple redirect where it's like, oh, I'm going to redirect the www.version to the non-www.version. That will work if all they're typing in is the domain. But it fails if they type in the domain /home or /something-awesome. You need some kind of dynamic rule that says anytime anything is typed in, it's going to redirect and also carry that path is what it's called, the portion after the forward slash. And so in here, you see this is the rule. And so it's a forwarding rule. If I go back, if I was to create this, it's a forwarding rule. And we're going to start with the version that we don't want to see, right? So my example, this is the one that has the proxy on. My example, you see, it doesn't have the www. So I'm saying I want to forward the secure version, https://domain.com/*. The /* is what tells it everything after as well. So dynamically, any path, any page, everything. And then the forwarding URL, you're going to do a 301 permanent redirect. And this is the formula. Your .com domain with the WWs, or feel free to do the reverse of this if you want it to not have the WWs. And then you do /money symbol and the #1. If you save this, now in all situations, in all scenarios, it will work. As you kind of expected, this is the kind of stuff that some hosts do by default. Like if you're familiar with WordPress or other websites, they'll sometimes ask, hey, do you want to use the WW or the non-WW? And you say, oh, I want the WW. And then it handles all these redirects. Most funnel builders don't. HighLevel doesn't. And this is why we use Cloudflare. That's why we love it, because I have this one rule, that simple setup of DNS records. I get the added benefit of security, stability, speed. And now, no matter what, every version of a URL that I want is going to work. And so now what all you have to do is add the version of the domain that you actually wanted. So in my case, it was www.thedemoaccount.com. Now it adds it in, successfully added. And so now if I have it on a funnel, it doesn't matter if someone types in with or without the WWs, it's going to work. It's going to be easy and it's going to be seamless. So you set it up once right and you'll love it. You try a different way because there's lots of different ways to do this. And I promise you there's going to be a version of a headache here. And so this is the most robust version that we found. This is the insight of supporting over 20,000 end users in HighLevel. And so to that point, if you have users that are using HighLevel as a SaaS, they're in your account and they're asking you questions about domains and you're like, oh my gosh, one person, I've got them on, they bought their domain from SiteGround, another person they bought their domain from Google Domains, another person they bought their domain from GoDaddy. One, how do I teach them how to do this? And two, what's the best way to do it? Well, I just gave you the best way to do it. But what we've done is we have white label videos and articles covering, I don't even know how many, 10 plus different scenarios, all driving them back to this super stable version of a domain setup, eliminating 98% of domain headache questions. And that's what we're doing. So if you haven't heard about us, hlpotools.com, we take care of all of your support issues with white label videos, white label articles, and actually a white label team handling your support issues on your behalf 24/7, and it's only $197 a month. So if you're having those headaches, hop on over to HL Pro Tools. We'll take care of them. But as always, happy to have you here and happy to deliver awesome hacks and shortcuts to make sure HighLevel is as painless as possible. Catch you on the next one.